Sandy should be available in a couple hours.
Let's see what they got.
I can't believe there could be any more surprises.
That's when they come. That's why they're called surprises.
So, do we now understand the LaGuardia's case?
Yes, I think I do.
Let me hear it.
Savage is obsessed with Palamas. She ditches him for another man. Savage becomes enraged. He can't let go. One night, knowing his wife will be going out, he calls her up, begs her to see him again. Carolyn finally agrees. She rolls around with him for auld lang syne, but then something goes wrong. Savage is jealous. He wants more than she's willing to give. He blows it, gives her what for with some heavy instrument, decides to make it look like rape. Savage is a prosecutor this way. He knows there'll be dozens of suspects. So he ties her up, opens the latches to make it look like someone slipped in. And this is the diabolical part. Pulls out her diaphragm so it looks like rape. But in his haste and confusion, he makes mistakes. He forgets the glass he drank from. He doesn't think the forensic chemist will be able to ID the spermicide. But we know he did evil to this woman, because he lied about his presence in her apartment on the night she was killed. His fingerprints on the glass. His blood type A identified from semen. Fibers from the carpets in his home tell us he was there.
Very convincing.
But their evidence of motive is weak.
There's where we must attack. Is there any proof of prior amorous relationship between the defendant and the decedent?
Just a few telephone calls.
That can be accounted for by business needs. Any diary?
No.
No note that came with flowers? No lover's correspondence?
No.
Good. Gossip will not be admitted.
But there are telephone calls from my home to Carolyn's apartment all through October of last year.
I believe you were trying the case of Wendell McGaffney during that period. Reason enough for calling her.
Why did I tell the Pranzer not to get my home telephone records?
I take it for granted that a person of an innocent state of mind would rule himself out as a suspect and save a busy detective from wasting time. Clearly, they hope to win the case on the strength of their physical evidence.
I would like to get a look at that glass. It could help me to figure some things out.
List a motion for production of physical evidence.
I don't want a complete inventory of everything in that apartment.
Where's the contraceptive gel you're... Whatever it is this chemist is saying he finds present, wouldn't it be in her medicine cabinet?
I don't know.
I'm gonna hear worse in court.
I never asked her what she was doing.
One word of caution. We do not want to lead De La Guardia to evidence he has not thought to obtain. Best we conduct the search ourselves without disclosing our intentions. Also, your mention of Carolyn's personal habits leads to this thought. We should subpoena her doctors. Who knows what we might discover?
There is one big surprise, however. Raymond Horgan's on their witness list. Why?